Good morning, grade 11. So last time, I discussed to you the history and the meaning of badminton. So as part of your attendance in physical education too, I want you to record a voice record on Messenger, on our group chat Messenger, and send to me your brief explanation on how the badminton starts. So I will listen to your voice record, or I will listen on how you understand the lesson, which is the history of the badminton. So now, as a recap of our discussion regarding the badminton, I will discuss to you one by one the equipment in playing badminton. So by the end of this discussion, I will learn to you, I will explain to you how did the badminton play and what precautionary standard or techniques you'd like to apply in playing the badminton. So first type of equipments in badminton is the court or the home court. So as the definition itself, for the single elimination of the badminton, it measures for 44 feet long and 17 feet wide. So for the double elimination round of the badminton, double elimination badminton, it measures 14 feet long and 20 feet wide. So as you can see on the court, so it is served as the right and the left court. Yan. Meron siyang the center line. Diyan na pwesto yung kapag ka, yung opponent or yung kalaban is nandun sa service line, nandun sa kabila. So, dun sila na pwesto. So, each goal or each court must have the service line. So, katulad din siya ng volleyball, syempre may service line through the single and double elimination. So, court of badminton, it measures the right and left court. Yan. So, tandaan natin, for the single elimination, we have the 44 feet long and the 17 feet wide. For the double elimination, it measures 44 feet long and 20 feet wide. Next, the official court measures 44. Yan, sinaulit ko lang kanina. And as I fit Ali, on each side, commonly referred as a double alley. So, yung tinatawag po natin na double alley, sila yun nandun sa double elimination. So yung measures nun is magkaiba dun sa single elimination round. So, ang pinagkaiba nga lang niya is kung gaano or mas malaki yung extension ng court ng double elimination or ng doubles kaysa dun sa single. Then, there also space 2.5 feet wide at the both ends of the court, which are the back alley. So there are two service areas on each side of the net, to the right and left service court, bounded by a line running parallel to the net called the short service. So meron tayong tinatawag na back alley. Ito siya. So end line ng court. Yan, ito. So, yun yung tinatawag nating back alley. Kung saan, kapag ka dyan tumama yung bola, dyan maa-out yung inyong team. Kasi, bawal siyang tamaan. So, as part ng double elimination or the single elimination, kailangan gamitin mo ang short service line para hindi tumama dun sa back alley. Next, so the ceiling height should be 30 feet of the official game and 24 feet of instructional game. The floor surface is traditionally wood, but mainly synthetic and plastic court have been developed. So, nakakita naman kayo ng official court ng badminton. So, mamaya, i-discuss sa inyo kung ano yung equipment na under ng court. Yan. Yun yung first equipment ng badminton, which is the net. So, the net should be made of dark colored mesh. So, 2.5 feet deep with a 1.5 inch wide tape extending across the top. So, the top of the net should be 5 feet above the floor at the point equidistant from the sidelines and 5 feet and 1 inch in height at point above the double sideline. So, normal na ginagamit na net is from color dark, color moist. So medyo ang tinatawag po natin na dark colored moist ito. Yan. Ito yung surface ng dark color moist. So it measures 2.5 feet deep with a 1.5 inch white tape. So yung sa net kasi ng badminton is medyo mababa lamang kasi hindi naman siya katulad dun sa badminton, sa volleyball na mas mataas ahead from our head. Magkaiba siya dun sa net ng badminton. So proceed po tayo sa post. So under ng net nandiyan yung post with 5 feet and 1 inch in height from the floor. So ganun lang yung taas ng post na dapat nagagamitin sa badminton net. Next, the racket. It should be light, can be made of wood, aluminum, metal, or synthetic materials such as graphite or carbon. It can be up to 68 centimeters long and it is usually weighs about 100 grams. So racket is made, it can be made of wood, aluminum, metal, and synthetic material. So racket, kadalasang ginagamit sa racket is yung synthetic material. So maganda ang gamitin yung wood kasi siya yung matibay at saka masarap gamitin kasi medyo magaan. So magandang gamitin yung original na racket kaysa dun sa mga synthetic material na madaling masira kapag ka ikaw ay natira. Minsan kasi yung surface ng racket madali siyang nabubutas kapag ka hindi magandang klase. Kaya hindi advice na gamitin yung synthetic materials para sa racket. So racket mousetrings are made of synthetic such as nylon, but world class players use lamb. Yan. So kung ang ginagamit na surface ng racket is nylon dito sa Pilipinas. Yan. Ito yung nylon, which is commonly na ginagamit. Sa ibang bansa, ang ginagamit is lamb. So, GATT is more expensive than synthetic and has a disadvantages of a short lifespan when strung tightly or not protected from most structure. String diameter ranges from 19 to 22 gauges. So, racket, so sa pagmahal ng ginagamit na synthetic string sa pagtibay. So, kung ang bibilhin nyo is yung GATT or yung lamb na ginagamit ng mga professional player ng badminton, mas maganda. Pero, kung ang gagamitin mo lang is synthetic materials na nabibili lang sa ibang sa mga store, hindi po siya applicable na gamitin para sa racket. Then, racket is most competitive players prefer 21 to 22 gauge strong string to 14 to 15 pounds of tension that provides power and control for school and recreational use with 20 gauge string at the tension of 12 to 13 pounds is adequate. So sa paggaan ng paggamit ng racket, mas masarap gamitin or mas matibay siya. For school, syempre ordinary use lang ang ginagamit sa raketa or sa racket. So, may kabigatan ng konti. Pero dapat ang gagamitin natin is yung magaan para flexible mong gamitin pagdating sa laro. Next, the shuttlecock. It is made of 14 to 16 goose feathers that are placed in leather covered cork head made of either plastic or nylon. Synthetic shuttles are suitable for recreational games, but feathered or official shuttlecock weighs from 4.74 to 5.50 grams. So the shuttlecock, yan, ito yung tinatawag nating cork base. And it can be hard or soft. So cork base, it is the upper layer of the shuttlecock. So it is the feather. It can be made of feather or the nylon. Pero mas magandang gamitin natin is yung the feather kasi mas masarap siyang gamitin. And for the shuttlecock, meron is aesthetic ways kung paano magkakaroon ng isang shuttle ka, kailangan 4.74 to 5.50 grams ang bigat niya bago mo gamitin sa paglalaro. So, sa pagganda, siyempre, sa pagganda ng klase ng ginagamit na shuttlecock, mas magaan para gamitin ito sa paglalaro. Yan. How to play badminton? So, do you want to know how to play badminton? Or meron na ba kayong idea on playing how the badminton? So playing consists of volleying, hitting the shuttle back and forth over the net without allowing it to hit the ground. The shuttle is made of the feathers or the nylon in cork base. It flies slowly when hit gently, but when hit hard and timed perfectly, it may travel at more than 300 kilometers per hour. However, the shuttle decelerates quickly after the short distance. So, badminton is just like a volleyball sports. So, it is a combination of shuttlecock, which travel from the other component of your team, and from throwing to the other component, so may corresponding points na matatanggap. So it is a continuous way of distribution of shuttlecock to other component as your kalaban. So through the use of badminton, siyempre, kapag yung paggamit mo ng shuttlecock or nun sa raketa is medyo parang katulad din siya ng volleyball, na kapag kinalaban mo yung bola, siyempre mataas yung talon, may tendency na ma-out yung bola. Ganun din siya sa badminton. So kapag yung ang gigil na gigil ka sa pagpalo ng shuttlecock, may tendency na mas lumayo yung pagtalsik ng bola, hindi siya magkakaroon ng points sa iyong team. So the shuttlecock is serves with the underhand motion of the opponent service court diagonally opposite. So the server must hit the shuttle while it is below his waist. The racket head must also be below the serving hand only to attempt. Only one attempt at the serve is allowed. If the server fails, then the opponent serves. So nandito na po tayo sa rules and regulation in playing badminton. Siyempre, meron po tayong ginagamit or standard on playing badminton. So, only one attempt serve is allowed. So, laging ganun naman na kapag ka nagsuserve ka, kailangan diretso na. Pero pag hindi mo siya natamaan, meron kasi kapag titira ng badminton, hindi natatamaan yung shuttlecock. So, ang tendency nun, yung point and yung chance ng service ay mapapunta sa kalaban. So, how to handle the badminton racket? So, ano nga ba yung mga ginagamit or ano yung mga way kung paano hawakan ang badminton racket? So, nandiyan na yung una, yung forehand grip. So, it refers to any shot struck on the racket side of the body. So, forehand grip, it is commonly used kapag sa beginners. So, mamaya ipapakita ko sa inyo kung ano nga ba yung angle kung paano gamitin yung forehand grip. So backhand grip, these are the host struck of the sideway from the racket, left and right hand, right-handed, right side for left-handed. So dito yung mga ano, sa backhand grip yung nahihirapan or medyo hindi sanay pag right and left-handed ka. So, yan. Ano yung pinagkaiba ng dalawa? So, through the use of forehand grip, ito lang yung pinakaiba nila ha. Ayan. Yung kamay ng forehand grip is opposite or nakakapit sa buong raketa or dun sa pinakahawakan. So, sa backhand grip, ito siya. Ayan. Kung mapapansin natin sa picture na malaki ang pinagkaiba ng forehand grip sa backhand grip. So, depende naman yun sa gamit. Yung forehand grip and backhand grip is just only precautionary measures that you may use to play badminton. But kung saan kayo mas prepare yung gamitin o mas saan kayo sanay gamitin, syempre, dun kayo sa mapapadali, kung saan kayo mapapadali. Next, proceed po tayo with the four common strokes in badminton. So, dito, ituturo ko sa inyo kung ano yung pwedeng technique or strategy on how to become a flexible and have a technique in playing badminton. So, ano yung mga technique na pwede nyong gamitin sa paglalaro ng badminton? Yan. Nauna na dyan yung tinatawag nating clear. So, clear, it is also called lob. The shuttle soars in a high arc and falls into the court behind the opponent. Use the forehand overhand position. Bring the racket from behind the body with the head up. Strike the shuttle at the highest point of reach when your arm is fully extended just before the moment of impact. Use a forceful wrist snap so the shuttle is hit up and toward the baseline in the opponent's court. When hitting with this stroke, the racket follows the same path as is thus in the line serving expect the left side 15 toward the direction of the bird flight. So, clear, it is very easiest way in playing badminton. So, through the use of clear, using the forehand, overhand position, ito yung sinasabi niyang overhand, forehand position. So, ililift mo yung racket, ililift mo yung shuttlecock. Tingnan yung direction ha. So, nag-overhand siya, yan. Maghahanap siya ng target na papatakan. So, it states that the clear is just only for overhand or overhead your shuttlecock to the other opponent. So, kapag natira mo, sa pamagitan nun din naka-score ka, it is called clear. So, matik yon na may 1 point ka na agad. So, tingnan yung direction ha. Next, so the drop. Drop is a shuttle falls gently and just clear the net. The flight Sorry po sa music. So, the shuttle falls gently and just clear the net. So, the flight of the bird is relatively slow and is hit using the forehand and backhand side with the accuracy. So, bring arm from behind the body and extend completely at the impact of the shuttle. Follow with a wrist snap and let the bird follow straight line and drop just over the net. The follow through is minimum. So, as you can see, the drop can be used. It is just only like the clear. So, ang drop po ay ginagamitan ng forehand at saka ng backhand side ng kamay. So, through the use of this illustration, so the drop is just only shape. Kasi minsan lalapit dito yung opponent, dito nandito yung player. Yan. Malapit siya dun sa net. Kapag hindi mo siya ginamitan ng drop, maaring lulusot yung agad yung shuttlecock sa iyo. So, syempre, lalapit ka dun sa kalaban. And then, automatically, yung parang peke siya kung ang tawagin. So, slow, pagpalo dito sa taas, then drop as fast as you can. So, through the use of the drop or the drop shot, makaka-score ka. Ano nga? So, meron kasi na component na ginagawa yung slow drop. Parang peke na kunwari titira sila ng malakas pero pagpalo is mahina lang. So, dapat attentive ka sa paglaro ng badminton. Yung ways ng pagpalo or ng pagsambot ng shuttlecock is aligned sa iyong paglalaro. Next, the smash. So, smash is the hard stroke. Hit sharply downward. Bring the arm from behind the body with the elbow bent. Then forcefully extend your arm overhead to contact the shuttle. The shuttle must be hit with a strong straight downward position and a tremendous wrist snap. The shuttle must be hit at the highest possible point and in front of the body. Make sure that you are able to make the shuttle travel downward the great speed. So, smash is most commonly used for the professional and for the badminton player also. So smash through, through overhead, yan, through the combination of your body, swing up. Yan, kita yung direction, the non-rocket arm. So kung makikita nyo, kasama sa pag-swing mo is yung hatak or pagbuelo mo sa pagtira. Kapag ka kasi medyo malakas yung tira ng kalaban, syempre tatapatan mo din siya ng smash. So, through the use of your body, yan, buelo ka. Tapos, kunin mo yung shuttlecock sa taas, then smash ng malakas. Hanggang sa maaabot mo yung... Wag lang sobra kasi pagka yung tira mo, tapos smash sa sobra, may tendency na ma-out. Next or last type of techniques in badminton is the drive. So drive, it is a hard stroke hit on straight line. This is the last moving shuttle that follows horizontal path from one court to the other. Bring racket back to the shoulder level, followed by swing in which the racket head remains the parallel of the floor. So the shuttle is struck in front of the body and the wrist snaps at the moment of impact. So the right arms follow through across the body to the shoulder level of the left side. See, it is a shuttle flies low to the L seat, easy to return. So through the use of drive, yan. So and drive po is the last step or the last, kapag sinasanay ka na dun sa drop, kapag nasanay ka na dun sa clear, kapag nasanay ka na dun sa smash, may a-apply na po natin yung drive. So drive is the continuous way or the continuous hitting the shuttlecock to your other opponent. So through the use of drive, through the use of drive, may tendency na mas tumagal yung laro and then mas is intense. So, mas madali ka makaka-point kapag ka ginamit mo yung drive. Kapag ka-continuous na yung paglaro and then hindi sanay yung kalaban, so nasanay ka dun sa tatlong technique na tinuro ko, which is the drive, drop, the clear, and the smash. So, magiging good player ka. So, through the use of the technique that I teach to you today, so, may tendency na kapag na-apply mo ito sa iyong sarili, may magagamit mo siya into the future. So as a recap, so there are different equipments in playing badminton, which is the court, the net, the post, and shuttlecock and the racket. Then in handling the badminton racket, the forehand and the backhand grip. Then for the last I discuss to you is the four commonly stroke, which is the clear, the drop, the smash, and the drive. So those concept of the badminton. So that's all for today, and goodbye.